All over the world today, there seems a phenomenon that is sweeping across the land. A sport with an intensity and awareness that soars above the rest, one that pushes the human boundaries to its physical and mental limit. A sport that finally answers the question everyone asks themselves: what am I truly made of? It is the fastest rising sport in popularity today, and it is mixed martial arts, otherwise known as MMA. Boxing, Muay Thai, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Judo, and wrestling are its essential components. Derived from ancient Roman combat sport, from there it is spread throughout Europe, Brazil, Pacific Rim, and the U.S. into the turn of the 20th century, and now it's found its way deep into the heart of Texas. MMA is only a couple of decades young in the Dallas area. Here in Louisville, a Golden Gloves winning boxer with a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu trains daily. Pro fighter Marcus the Wrecking Ball Hicks is a popular MMA veteran who in 2007 opened the doors to his private academy, Hicks MMA.
Who shot ya? Separate the weak from the ops. Leap hard to creep them Brooklyn streets. It's on, nigga. Fuck all that bickering beef. I can hear sweat trickling down your cheek. Your heartbeat sound like Sasquatch feet. Thundering, shaking the concrete. Then the shit stop when I fall the plot. Neighbors call the cops.
Here, Hicks is preparing for a major fight in the Dominican Republic in the coming month. Alongside Hicks is friend and protege Brandon Wyatt. Brandon is training for his pro boxing debut in Austin, Texas later this week.
Slow like blunts with yayo. Peel more skins than Idaho potato. Niggas know the lyrical molesting is taking place. Fucking with B.I.G. it ain't safe. I make your skin chafe. Rashes on the masses. Bumps and bruises. Blunts and Land Cruisers. Big Papa smash fools. Bad fools. Niggas mad.
I started fighting way when I was about 10 years old. It's been about 11 years now. Working out is an everyday thing. I mean, like I said, I train about 3 times a day at least. I mean, cardio is every day. Yeah, that's about a pound and a half, man. Jump rope with that ain't no joke. This motherfucker right there. When it comes down to fight time, you gotta cut weight, and that's like the worst part of fighting, cutting weight. I mean, sometimes you gotta starve yourself for a couple days, dehydrated. Everything is not fun, but after you get that win, it's all worth it, you know? I mean, it pays off.
I seen the light excite all the freaks. Stack mad chips, spread love with my peeps. Niggas wanna creep, got to watch my back. Think the cognac and endo sack make me slack. I switches all that, cock sucker G's up. One force move, get Swiss cheese up. Click to tech, respect, I demand it.
Well, I mean, when you coming out to the ring, I mean, you're nervous. I ain't gonna lie, you're gonna be nervous. But just imagine what the other guy's going through. And imagine all of the training that you did. You can't just, you know, be scared and just go in there and give up. You gotta go in there and put the training to work. I always gotta make room for boxing. It's a full-time job, and it's my career. That's gonna be the money maker right there. Sooner or later, it's gonna happen.
Hicks MMA also provides a platform for a particular fighter who made his way to the Dallas area all the way from Israel.
My name is Lior, Shporen, born and raised in Israel. All this combat sport basically just relieve all kind of stress out of you. You know, you kind of pissed off during the day, or you're stressed, or you name it. You just know that at the end of the day, you come to the gym and you just let it go. You just let everything go. And the next day, I mean, you're just so relaxed. I mean, during the day, I'm a very mellow person. Nothing bothers me. You can get me mad. You say whatever you want. I'm okay. I'm good. Then at the end of the day, I come here to the gym and work on the back and get to train and spar with some fighters over here. And like I said, just just drains you. You just get done the workout, you're worn out. You can't even get mad if you want to.
Just minutes down the road from Hicks MMA is Mohler Mixed Martial Arts in Cahill. The gym's head coach is Alan Mohler, a third-degree black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, the 2008 North American Grappling Association Instructor of the Year, and has nearly 30 years' experience in various martial arts. He opened the doors to his academy in Texas in 1995 with the dream of establishing a world-class training facility. Through hard work, dedication, and commitment, Alan has succeeded in establishing his academy as one of the most highly regarded in the United States. Gyms like Mohler's are producing fighters at an astonishing rate, and the influx of talent in the area is just getting started.
It's a very rewarding job because you see people come in, maybe they don't have a lot of confidence, maybe they aren't in very good shape, and all of a sudden, 4 or 5 months goes by and you see them with that confidence. You know, you see them drop that 40 or 50 pounds and they're a whole new person. So not only are you making a living, but you're changing other people's lives. Only your top 2-3% of the MMA fighters in the whole world get into the big shows. Can it happen? Yes. It's a little bit easier right now because the sport is growing so fast. Mohler's MMA has been in the UFC, the WEC, the ESPN, the Versys, the Spike TV. We've been in all those, but it's kind of like you're only as good as your last fight. So you got to have another young and up-and-coming fighter to step up to the plate and hope he has what it takes. It's almost like winning the lottery. You know, you just have that white person walk through your door. You don't even know that he's going to be that someone. And then all of a sudden, he's that someone.
Mohler's is also home to professional fighter and instructor Jason Sampson. Jason Sampson was a self-confessed trouble kid, getting into trouble for fights in school and experimenting with drugs. He now uses those bad experiences to maintain his focus on becoming a better person in life and a better fighter in the cage. He's now a world Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and grappling champion and holds 1 pro and 3 amateur and title belts from Ring Rulers and Texas Lone Star Beatdown. Sampson's ultimate goal is to fight in the UFC, the most popular MMA promotion on the planet. This goal seems only months away for him. Campuzano, another prospect that works and trains at Mohler's, is already at the pinnacle of the sport. He is preparing for his UFC debut later this week at the Palms, located in the fight capital of the world, Las Vegas. Campuzano is of the top caliber of bantamweight strikers in the world today and will make history by competing in the first 135-pound fight in UFC history.
I'm from Acapulco, Mexico. Immigrated to the States when I was 2 years old. I don't know, back in 2005, before I ever started training, you know, I used to buy the UFCs and watch the DVD tapes, and I always told myself, you know, I'd love to one day do that, and, you know, I think from that day on, I just set, you know, forward with my goal, and slowly, you know, there's definitely a lot of pressure, you know, with me being a striker and having a lot of knockouts in my record. You know, I got to go out there and try to put a great show on.
And what a tennis. devastating kick from Campuzano.
It's only, you know, I'm going to go out there and put it all out there. You know, if I'm losing those two rounds, I'm just going to go try flying knees all over the third, see if something lands. Finally made it to the big show, and man, there's not one day I regret.
For many fighters, a level of competition requires more than just the fighting essentials and natural talent. To get an edge, many fighters look into extreme conditioning methods. Here at CrossFit in Deep Ellum, the majority of workouts utilize a combination of weightlifting, gymnastics, and metabolic conditioning exercises using varying rep schemes and loads to deliver optimal fitness. The intensity of the workout is exactly what today's fighters need to succeed in battle. With the popularity of MMA rapidly growing in the Dallas area, many young up-and-comers' dreams of one day making it to the big show mean practice, hard work, and dedication are needed to reach these dreams. Future hopeful Lewis Gines is willing to do whatever it takes to accomplish this task.
Seeing the fighters on TV kind of inspires me to want to make a living. I want to go out there and do the same things that they do, become a champion. And hopefully, if everything works out, I'll be able to. And I think that, well, basically, that'll be everything that I wanted in life, to be great at something. If I can make a living off fighting, there's nothing else in the world that I want.
As MMA keeps rapidly growing in popularity all over the world, it's only a matter of time before it will be accepted among the other popular traditional sports. Time will tell, and day by day, the sport will continue to evolve, and a new fighter will be born.